Welcome back to another Honkai Impact 3 video. It's your homie Cody GT, and today's video, my boys, we are going to do a showcase gameplay of the new Valkyrie on the global side of Honkai Impact 3, which is, I believe it's pronounced Zele, if I'm not mistaken. I've been saying Seely, which I think that's incorrect. I believe it's Zele. But in the comments below, let me know. I'm probably saying that wrong as well. But we're going to go ahead and do a showcase gameplay of her, show her off for a little bit because she is brand new and I do have her, and I thought it would be really cool to go ahead and show her off, see what she's able to do and kind of go over her kit and kind of show what she's capable of. So I do hope you enjoy the video. If you do, go ahead and drop a like. It's greatly appreciated. It means a lot to me. And if you're new to the channel, you enjoy the content, you like what you see, go ahead and consider subscribing, joining the family today as we are on our way to 10,000 subscribers. We're almost at 6,000, so that is awesome. The love and support from you guys, it's always greatly appreciated. So with that being said, let's go ahead and let's take a look at Zele. I believe I'm saying that right. And see what she's capable of. Now, right off the bat, let me go ahead and say that she is not OP meta Valkyrie. She's not going to go ahead and change the meta for you. As far as like in Memorial Arena and, you know, Abyss and things of that nature, she's not going to be that type of Valkyrie for you. And she's not the most powerful Valkyrie like Hersh of the Void or Vermilion Knight or Shadow Knight. But she is a really good A rank Valkyrie, a very good farmable free to play Valkyrie, and I enjoy her a lot. I really do. So let's go over her kit. So we have a new typing, by the way, quantum typing, which is really cool. This is something new that has come with Zele, and she brings a little more dynamic to the game. So that's awesome with that new quantum typing. So as you can see on the graph, she is a good burst, good damage type of Valkyrie, good survivability because of her evasion and things of that nature. And we'll see from her skills, she does a bit of debuffing. Now, her features is the melee AoE DPS, enters warp state after evading enemy attack, burst mode DPS spike, ultimate evasion extends burst damage or duration, excuse me. Now, that's what she's really all about, is that burst mode and that burst damage. You'll notice you get the most benefit from Zele when you use her ultimate. That's where she really shines and she really outputs the most damages during that ultimate. Now, speaking about that, the ultimate, assume the powers of the Shadow Avatar and enter burst mode. Perform a multi-sequence shuttle attack to deal 6 times 150% attack of physical damage. Gain Avatar powers to deal 2 times 200% plus 600% attack of physical damage. Then enter burst mode to gain 250 veil. Final blow applies Veliona's, I believe I said that right, binding and one quantum implosion against QUA enemies. So that'll be quantum type enemies as well. So she does a bit, she's a little bit better against them. Now, burst, gain crit multiplier for basic attack and 50% total damage reduction. Tap and hold attack to spend an evasion to deal a special shuttle attack and trigger plane warp. Spend 30 veil per half second. Max duration 18 seconds. Cooldown 25 seconds. FP cost 110. So the ultimate is where she shines. The ultimate is going to be her bread and butter, so that's what you want to keep in mind. Now, her leader skill, Azure Nymph, team gains 14% crit rate in burst mode. If Bronya is in the team also gains 10% total damage multiplier. That's really cool, kind of goes along with the story. Having Bronya on the team gives your whole team a better damage multiplier buff, so not a bad team leader skill. You can actually use that. Now, for the applicable formation, this is actually, in my opinion, a really good formation to have if you plan on having Zele as your main damage dealer. Now, the team formation I was using was this Yamabuki Armor Bronya augmented, and I was also using Zele, of course, and then I was using my augmented Valkyrie Blade Strike Striker Fulminata. That was actually a really good combination for me, and I'll actually show that off in this gameplay because they trigger the QTEs for each other really well, and there's a lot of good synergy. But this one's a good one as well. Like I mentioned, if you plan on having Zele as your main DPS, I bring Striker Fulminata because Sele is not always going to be my main DPS, and so I switched to Striker Fulminata, and then she just puts in work. But this is a good one. So Yamabuki Armor provides the damage, absorbing shield to provide more DPS opportunities, of course, and then Celestial Hymn to be able to bring the enemies together, do large AoE damage, and also to provide impair on the enemies to debuff them, so you could do more physical damage. So that's a good formation. Now for the applicable weapons, if you did not see my summoning video, I did pull the weapon as well as two of her stigmatas. Now I know there's a better stigmata set out there that you can go ahead and form, but the one that I have on her just right now, because it's what I have, is the two Dirac set and Attila bottom, just for that physical damage. So that's what I have on her. We'll see that in just a second. But the weapon is extremely crucial, because that's what plays a huge role for her providing more damage as well as more veil. You can see it right here. I'm actually not going to go ahead and read it because I read it in my last video. So if you want, you can pause the video, take a look over it, see what it does. It's really, really good. And then the stigmas, they provide crit rate and burst effects and physical damage and SP recovery, which is really, really good. Now getting the third one, it would be nice, but you know, it's okay. Now if you didn't notice, I do have Sele at A rank, so I'm actually working on getting her to S rank, so you can see I'm about halfway there. So that is a bit of a rip. I'm probably gonna update this, do an update video on Sele once I get her to S or double S rank, and then you know, max out some more of her stuff, because as you can see with the weapon, almost maxed out, close. But not really there. And then as you can see for the stigmatas, close, but not maxed out. So I think I'll do an update video showing her fully maxed out with everything. I just don't have the materials right now. I don't have the materials to max out the weapons, the stigmatas, and I don't have the coin to max out her skills. Unfortunately, pains me, but I don't have it. So I'm working on getting the materials, so I'll do an update video and you know, see what she's really capable of. But going over her skills, because they are really good. The first one, recover SP with charge attack, very nice. Charge attack debuffs enemies, slowing them and making them take more damage from the character, which is really good. The QTE triggered by time slow recovers veil and SP and activates a phase warp state. That's really good also. Moving over here, burst kills can be linked to the special shuttle attacks. Enemy with Veliona's binding take more damage from the character. And then we have triggering plane warp gains more veil. And this one, which is locked behind the S rank, character deals more physical damage. Special shuttle attacks also deal more damage. I mean, that's pretty crucial. Getting her to S rank is pretty crucial, because it unlocks a lot for her. Now this one, gain veil when basic attack hits. That's just pretty standard. And then for her evasion, ultimate evasion recovers more veil and have faster cooldown. Phase warp lasts longer and gives more damage reduction, which is great. I love the damage reduction. Now the one that's locked behind S rank, during plane warp deals more physical damage and get faster attack SP recovery. I mean, that's just crucial. Deal more damage against impaired enemies, locked behind the S rank, and then locked behind the double S rank, gain crit damage at a high combo hit count. So I mean, those are all really, really crucial. And then gain veil by killing enemies, which is, that's great, that's awesome. And then just the leader skill. So those are her skills. That is what she's capable of. Like I mentioned, getting her unlocked at S rank and double S rank is just really, it's really necessary, because it allows her to deal more damage, really unlocks her potential. So that's what I'm going to plan on doing, and then I'll do an update video. But that is Sele. That is all that she is about as far as her skills, her equipment, and her kit. So let's go ahead, let's jump into some gameplay. Let's see what she's all about. In the comments below, let me know if you've been using her, let me know if you've been enjoying her, and let me know if she is a kind of a mainstay Valkyrie on your lineups. But let's go ahead, let's jump over to the gameplay. All right, my boys, so I decided just to go ahead to open world. Best way for me to go ahead and show her off in the gameplay. Also because in Dirac Sea, I'm not at a respectable floor. So let's go ahead, let's show her off in the open world. Cue my fighting music. Let's get to work. boys, so that was the showcase. That was the gameplay. I hope you enjoyed what you saw today, and I hope you enjoyed the content. Now, like I mentioned earlier in the video, as you can see, she's not going to be a meta-changing Valkyrie for you. She does good damage, but it's not anything off the charts. Also, keep in mind, I have her at A rank. I don't have her at S or double S, so she's going to be much more viable at those ranks, as well as I don't have her gear maxed out. So that's another thing to keep in mind as well. But she's a good Valkyrie. She does a lot for you. As you can see, I was never in trouble of health because she, you know, has a damage reduction and the impair on the enemies. Her survivability is really good because of her frame rates when she's doing her attacks. She shuttle transports. So those things really are good qualities when it comes to Zelaya. And obviously, you know, they will probably come out with an S rank version of her, and that'll be much better. But in my opinion, she's a really good free-to-play A rank Valkyrie that you can go ahead and have on your account. Have some really good unique effects, and just enjoyable to play with. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you like what you saw today. And with that being said, I'm going to get out of here. Remember to stand out, be different, have fun, go further beyond in everything that you do. And until next time, my boys, until next time, it's your homie Cody GT, and I'm out.